لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سواه.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين. أحمدك ربي على كل قضائك وجميع قدرك، حمد الرضا بحكمك لليقين بحكمتك، وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقك ونور عرشك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to our program. First of all, we make dua to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant shifa and speed recovery to those who are ill at home or in a hospital. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him shifa on kamil and speed recovery. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant the family of the sick people reward and sabr and ajr inshallah for that wonderful help and to take care of the sick people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Brother and sister in Islam, once again we say shukran for your emails, WhatsApp and phone calls. On behalf of all my friends here, we say shukran jazilan that you're tuning to our program. And I'd like to send special salam to our respected Muslims, brothers and sisters, and our students, and our shuyukh and ulama and maulanas in Soweto, especially on Protea South. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala reward you for that wonderful da'wah work in Soweto. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. I don't want to mention the people who are doing that wonderful work of da'wah, but I'm very proud of our Muslim brothers and sisters in Soweto here in Johannesburg. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them. I was there and I enjoyed the gathering with them, and I was very proud of them. Our African brothers and sisters, they carrying the flag of Islam with love and muhabba and sincerity. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala reward all of them, inshallah. They don't want me to mention their names, but we're very proud of our African brothers and sisters and the da'i in that beautiful city. It's called Soweto here in Johannesburg, especially Protea South. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Brother and sister in Islam, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has said that لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. Indeed, you have in the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a role model and example. And we do believe that we are insan, children of Adam. We are responsible to give imarat and to give a maintenance or to renovate that era which around us in our society. Every Muslim live in certain place, you must be a role model and good example for Muslim and for non-Muslim, and you must carry that flag of Islam, which is the deen of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. When we talk about domestic worker, those helper, those people Allah tabarak wa ta'ala send them to help us and to assist us with honor and dignity, we call them khadima or maid or domestic worker or the helper or whatever. We don't have slavery anymore. We have a helper. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even in the time of slavery, he said to the Ummah of Islam, don't say abdi, don't say my slave, say fataya and fatati. This is fatai, my boy, or this my girl, or that we call him the helper, or the one who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala send him to me to assist me and uplift me. And before we talk to this issue, especially here in South Africa, or maybe our neighboring country, or maybe on the Gulf countries or some other part of the world, you find someone help you. So this one, do you call him khadim, servant? No, we don't have that word. It's called servant in Islam. We call him my helper. So nowadays, you can't deal with the issue of life alone. You need a helper. But I want to remind you that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Fatima radiallahu anha, his daughter, came and asked him a helper, or you people call him servant, we call him helper, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam refused. And Fatima said, no, my work is too much, I need one girl to help me. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I'm going to help you. And he said, Fatima, read certain dhikr, read the prayer, Allah will give you barakah on the time and barakah at work, and you will do your work or your housework with love and inshallah with strength, and you will have energy. So you make istighfar and make dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you barakah. And that exactly what used to happen to our mothers and grandmothers. They never have a helper, but this old lady or this simple woman, she was doing the work, and the family was bigger than this, and there was no electricity, there was no technology, and a lot of barakah and energy till the last minute of her life. And we did see that in our life, that our mother has barakah, barakah at work, barakah in her life, barakah how that uneducated women without university, without internet, without media, without reading that type of philosophy, she brought to the ummah a wonderful ulama, huffaz, and professional. Ask everyone, those who did pass and did succeed in his life, behind him was a simple woman, wife, or aunties, or grandmother, or mother supporting him. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't like a maid to come inside the house of his daughter Fatima radiallahu anha. Reason for that is not only the social reason, it's also family reason. Number one, he said, house got some confidential life. So you can't keep a stranger inside your house to monitor you and to find you. Know the secret of your house, or to see the problem of the house, or try to do favor to your husband or to your wife without the wish of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He didn't like Fatima radiallahu anha to have a domestic worker. But halal, we're not saying haram or don't keep, but I'm telling you why Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The other thing also, once you have that domestic worker, you have to be very careful how to deal with her. And it's amana, kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'oolun an ra'iyyati. Everyone is a shepherd, and everyone has full responsibility for that flock which under him. So if the maid or the domestic worker make tea for your husband, and the husband say thank you, so you deprive yourself from serving your husband, oh, that courtesy between the couples. Another thing also, read about the problem which happened while you find the maid in the house, and you see, especially if the maid doesn't have iman or doesn't have the taqwa of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I'm not talking about all that domestic worker you do problem, but some of these cases, because of that robbery or some cheating or all that type of abuse because of the workers or those who you plan them in your family, which without having iman, without having the fear of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Plus, if you don't fulfill the right of the khadim, the domestic worker, you will have a question in qabr and akhirah, and it is one of your family member. You have to feed him, you have to give him clothes, you have to take care fully like your family member. Another thing also, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made some people like that. وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَكُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ. We elevated some above you, and you above the some. It means we elevated some above the some. But which some? You need the lady, so she's above you on that one. And then she needs the salary, you above her on that one. Brother and sister in Islam, we say to keep a domestic worker is not haram or anything, but Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not allow Fatima radiallahu anha to have that maid or that domestic worker for that reason which we mentioned. You, every human being, Allah asked him to work. He must help himself, he must serve himself. That because we are not relying on others. Everyone is khadim. All of us, we're serving Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and we're serving the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Islam asks me and you to help ourselves, not waiting for someone to assist you and to help you. On top of that, we mustn't forget that Nabi Musa alayhi salam was a servant to his father-in-law, Shu'aib alayhi salam, as a part of dowry. They paid the marriage dowry, mahar, that he must work 8 years as a shepherd to Nabi Shu'aib alayhi salam, and he give 2 years extra from himself. And we do believe that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a khadim, and but that it was a wish of the khadim himself, and sahaba also they had, but on top of that, by the end of the day, we are the khadim, we are the servant of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. All of us, we're seeking halal rizq, and that person is working with me, not working under me. We ask Rabbul Izzah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah accept all of us as a servant for Deenul Islam and the Muslimin, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. And once again, we say shukran jazeelan that you're tuning to our program. On behalf of myself and my cameraman and my sound engineer and all our friends on ITV studio, we say shukran jazeelan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use our ITV as a member of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and His Rasul. Before the break, I was talking about the seriousness to keep a person in your house. We're not saying it's not allowed or allowed, but you have to fulfill that condition or that rules which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us through the sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you decided to keep a maid or domestic worker or some helper in the house, so what is the first thing? You have to give him a fair payment. Fair payment, it means you must fear Allah when you deal or make agreement between you and this worker. Because some people, they misuse that need or the desperate need of the workers. You find foreigners or someone need a job and you kill him for hours or try to give him work which he is unable to do it. So you have to fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in payment. You must give him a fair payment which you can stand up in the day of Qiyamah and you prove it in the front of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So number one. Number two, you must not call him a servant. You must call him fatai, my boy or my girl or helper. There is no word is called servant, or you have to say my helper or my boy or my girl. The other thing also, give him the payment before his sweat get dry. The worker, he must feel that he's working for something, because to delay the payment, that is not Islamic act, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never put barakah on this work. So you give the ajir, the worker, his payment before his sweat get dry. And the ulama explain why, because when he's sweating, he's very, very tired, and then he need rehabilitation. Once he got the cash in his hand, he will forget his tiredness, his sweat, and then he will be ready to work more and more. Brother and sister in Islam, we have to give the worker his payment before his sweat gets dry, or if he agreed to delay it after the sweat, no problem, but the normal payment before the sweat get dry. The other thing also, we have to understand that you cannot give him work which is over, he was unable to do it. لا تكلفه ما لا يطيق ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. Allah doesn't allow himself to give you something, become burden on you, or you're unable to do it. So you cannot put that worker or that helper in such work, he's unable to do it. And then if you give him work which is over his capacity, you have to join him in work, you have to assist him and give him a hand. The other thing also, feeding the domestic worker, the helper, feeding from the same food you're eating. أَطْعِمْهُ مِمَّا تَأْكُلُ. So you must feed him from exactly. It's impossible for a Muslim to enjoy his meal. And we did talk to many friends when we discussed that issue there on in some workshop, on some da'wah program. Impossible to give that person a special plate or to give him the food which is left over, or you don't let him taste the food he's carrying and serving. Impossible. So he must taste the food which he was working in, Oh, you are helping. And the clothes, you must give him, you must clothing him. And we as a Muslim, we cannot enjoy our life while someone else less for our food and our clothes. We have to give him. Another thing also, no way to insult and to swear him or her at all. Not only workers or helper, any person. Muslim is not la'an. Muslim is not fahash. We're not allowed to use that rough word, or that unacceptable word, by threatening someone or shouting someone. So sab, impossible. And the ulama said, when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made that law of slavery, which many people think that Islam brought the slavery, never. Islam came while the slavery were there. Islam came to release the people. Fakku raqaba. So to release the people, not to make them slave. So if you beat your slave, or what is the kafara, how to repent from that type of sin, you have to free him. There is no other way. There is no sorry or anything. Once the master beat his slave, the only repenting, the only way to be with Allah and to please Allah after this, to free him. So that when you beat the slave, then the payment for that, or the punishment for the master, is to free the slave. Another thing also, if he deserves zakat and sadaqah, that helper or that worker, give him the zakat and sadaqah first. So you give him awla. Awla means he deserves it. That is the first choice. Right. He must eat with you. And I'm repeating again, these people must eat with you. No way to keep him aside or in a corner. That is not accepted in Islam. And he must ride the car next to you, not there at the back. This man is human being, is working under the permission of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So he must eat with you. And I know so many people are going to fight, but I'm telling you that is what Islam say. Eat with you, and he must sit next to you, not at the back or on the back seat. Another thing also, don't allow him to call you sir or master. As-sayyidu huwa Allah. There's nothing, it's called sayyidi. You know, when you people say my master, mistress, madam, or I don't know what you call it, sir. No, that sayyid is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So don't allow him to name you with some word. It's called Lord or my boss, or I don't know what this word here. Then do not use that need of the work to kill him. To kill him by giving him hard work, and because people nowadays they're struggling and suffering to get a job, so now you take advantage and you give him double job. Brother and sister Islam, this is Islam with this type of people. That's why I'm telling you, Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did not agree that Fatima must keep the helper, not because of the other problem we said, because of that rules and the difficulties how to fulfill the right of the workers. Another thing also, meaning of ajr, when you give him ajr, that agreement of payment between two parties. So let the opposite party, which is the helper, happy with the payment. Convince him, try to prove to him that it's a fair payment, and he must take it immediately. There is something after payment, it's called ma'ruf. What is ma'ruf? That favor you do it. He did not come to work one day, inshallah, Allah reward you for just grace him and give him some blessing for this one. We are insan. So what is ma'ruf? Give him a little bit more. It's a ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other thing also, you must forgive him. He's insan. This person is working with you, not under you. So make sabr. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never punish any helper or any worker ever. And the story of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the helper is so many. I don't want to waste our time by telling you that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no one incident did beat slave or worker or helper or even shouted him. Another thing also, that man, that person, that is a human being. So teach him, make sabr, be patient, tolerate till you teach him. The other thing also, be careful of oppressing these people, because in the day of Qiyamah there is going to be a court for that. Court for those who are powerless, they were under you, that ikhwanukum khawalakum, your helper are your brothers and sisters. Ja'alahum Allahu tahta aydikum. Allah made them under your command. Walau sha', if Allah want, He will make you under them. And we did see in our life, the master children, they work for the slave children nowadays. We did see it in our life that Allah turned the picture the other way around, and we see those people who used to rule the whole dunya, their children and grandchildren working under those people who used to work for them. That is the system of Allah, and this is the sunnah of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So fear Allah, because He can turn the situation the other way around and you work for them. Another thing also, oppressing these people, it's not a normal zulm, it's not a normal oppression. We got two types of zulm. Zulm al-andad. What is andad? The competitor, the contester. Two soap of power fighting each other. And then one oppresses the others. That one is called the oppression or injustice of the powerful person. That one here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave them till the day of Qiyamah. But when you find that powerful person, the one who got power, become aggressive and unfair to the powerless or helpless person, the justice of Allah must come immediately. That's called zulmu du'afa, the oppression of the powerless people. Be careful of that, because Allah is watching. Another thing also, play with them and try to be kind to them, so you will gain the heart and gain the sincerity of these people. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah forgive us for any injustice to anyone who below or under us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to Sirat al-Mustaqim. They ask me again to stop for a short break. Continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave us this opportunity to talk to you. And shukran jazilan for your comment. And we ask Rabbul Izzat tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah safeguard any Muslim from any type of zulm and oppression to ourselves or to the others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from any haram till we meet Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Brother and sister in Islam, I'd like to thank all our friends, those who send emails and SMSs and phone calls, and they ask me to put some comment on some other issue. And as I always say on my program, that this is not a fatwa program, is a da'wah program. We try to motivate people to have that pleasure of ibadah. We have to taste the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, look at the beauty of Islam. And I'm very proud of so many of non-Muslims. They meet us on different places, and they enjoy the ITV program. And especially when I went for the da'wah program in Johannesburg prison, and we see some church people or priests and some religious people out of the religion of Islam, they do watch. And they put some comment on our preaching, especially when we show the beauty of Deenullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to pass that message of Allah. I got quite few of the message from people who reach 40. And when we talk about those people who reach the age of 40, we know that is a serious age. You must know that you're under the spot. You are monitored by Allah and the angel, and you are in a serious age. Why are we saying that? Because many people, they think that the old age starts from 70, 80, but we believe that once you reach the age of 40, full responsibility on yourself, on the others, come on your shoulder, and you have to understand that it is serious age. When the person reached the age of 40, Allah is telling the angels, do not leave a single mistake of my servant, write it neatly and count it neatly. So my message today for those who reach the age of 40, definitely we are ummah of tawbah. Definitely there are so many ways to make tawbah. But unfortunately, when we encourage people to make tawbah and repent, we don't give them the technique how to make tawbah. Like we just give them some thought of general advice and say you must make tawbah. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. So teach me how I make tawbah. We have to convince the person, not only the one who reached the age of 40, any Muslim, baligh, aqil, responsible, will get hisab on the day of qiyamah. You must understand that is the only way to reach the love of Allah is to make tawbah. You cannot fight Allah and to be stubborn and to stand against the wish of Allah and you claim that Allah loves you. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. So I'm telling you now, there's no way to reach Allah pleasure without tawbah. Because the only way, when you make police clearance, we call it, you must delete all your problem. Reconciliation with Allah is tawbah. And subhanallah, Allah gave us so many ways to reconcile with Him, even one istighfar. Very easy, and tawbah is available and simple. It's in the hand of everyone. The other thing, the first ibadah on this earth, it was tawbah. That Adam alayhi salam, before fasting and salat and zakat, Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, he knows it. And you see that Rabbana innana zalamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna. The first ibadah of Adam alayhi salam is to make tawbah because he ate from the tree. So be like your Adam, your father Adam. You did make mistake. Make the first thing is called tawbah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ma halaka abdun istaghfar." That any servant will never get hurt if he makes istighfar. And we do believe that istighfar is the secret code of rizq of the children who to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right, istighfar, the tawbah itself, you'll enter Jannah through the tawbah. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala want to bless someone who died shaheed, we die with a sin, first thing on Akhirah is to forgive him. So it's called automatic tawbah. Another thing, sickness is dirt. It's very, very dirt. And this type of sickness, or the sinning is dirt. So we know that to commit a sin, you are not pure. So what happened for this one? Wash yourself. So wash yourself through the tawbah nasuha. We call it nasuha. Nasuha means the real and the absolute tawbah. When we say in Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin, washing yourself from the sin. Wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin, wash yourself from the physical dirt and physical filth come to us. So you got two type of washing. In Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin, those who wash their spirit. And يحب المتطهرين, those who wash their body. So it's, both of them is dirt. Another thing also, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, when He wrote for you to make tawbah and make istighfar, you come out from a group of the sinner, we call them musir. What is musir? Those who persist. Those who willing to do something haram. So ما أصر من استغفر ولو عاد 70 مرة. Even if you repeat the sin 70 times a day, you make that a sincere istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you are not persist. You are not musir. Another thing also, inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin. Allah loves those who repent. So if Allah loves you, He will never punish you. You know, some friend, he sent long SMS and tell me, you make the Jannah so easy. I say, Allah, it's easy. It's not me. Bashiru wala tunaffiru. Bashiru, it means give glad tidings. You always be positive. Wala tunaffiru, then let the people hate the meeting of Allah, because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is bashira wa nadhira. So what I'm trying to say, yes, very easy way to gain the pleasure of Allah and to save yourself from the fire of Jahannam. So once Allah loves you, He will never punish you. Finish. Don't listen to the others. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin. Impossible for the lover to punish his beloved one. Impossible. How you gain that love? Through the tawbah, repenting. Just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is tawwab, exaggeration of tawbah. It's called tawwab. Another thing, anyone who stick with istighfar, he love to make istighfar. When we say istighfar, you bring that intention of istighfar on your mind and your heart. Ma lazim al istighfar. من لزم الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل هم من فرجا. Anyone who loves to make istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove all the stress and depression and difficulties and will grant him ease. And all of us, we have that terrible feeling nowadays that we are enemy of Allah, we are not lucky, we don't achieve what we're looking for, because this is called ham. So make istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shower you with something you will never expect it. Another thing also, when we say kulli hammin faraja, this benefit of tawbah, it will ease your life, because to be enemy of Allah and beloved of Allah is not the same. It's a big difference between to live as an enemy of Allah, to fight him through the disobedience, and to become a beloved one to Allah and the lover of Allah. Another thing also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say tawwab rahim. Tawwab, the one who accept the tawbah. Rahim, he will never let you do it again. So from all the sin, and he will never ask you about that sin if he accept your repenting. So alhamdulillah, he will never ask you. Another thing, method of tawbah is very easy. Many people say, what can I do it? How I do it? And this is our problem when we teach people, we encourage people to make tawbah, say like what? Number one, make istighfar. Istighfar is called failing application of the repenting. So you ask Allah, alif sin ta, istighfar, seeking. So seeking means apply, application. Istinja, istisqa, you know, when you find an Arabic word, alif sin ta is this one. Another thing also, stop sinning. It's called practical tawbah. When we read the tafsir of Surah Al-Nur, and then we say, Az-zaniyatu la yankihuha illa zanin. The adulterer male, he married adulterer women. So the man who commit adultery must marry the lady who commit adultery. You say, no, but we see in our life that one man never makes zina in his life, and he married that. Say, no, wait, you can't interpret the ayah like this. Who are you now in the time of nikah? You make tawbah, you are not zani. And this lady made tawbah, impossible to call her zani, because she was zani, but nowadays she's not zani. Brother and sister in Islam, the door of tawbah open 24 hours. Allah's name is Tawwab, so what we need, one further step, and just to know how to practice that tawbah and bring it to the action. Inshallah, I will tell you more about the practical tawbah after short break. Short break, we'll come back to you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam, and say shukran that you're tuning to our program. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah accept all our tawbah. May Allah write all of us amongst tawabin, mutatahirin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us from any type of sin. Brother and sister in Islam, the method of tawbah is to stop sinning. Cut off that crime and prove it to Allah in a practical way that you're no more doing it. Before the break, I was talking about some ayah said, Az-zaniyatu la yankihuha illa zanin aw mushrik. So when we talk about it, At-tayyibuna lil-tayyibat wal-khabithuna lil-khabithat, many people don't understand that ayat, and you take just a general meaning or a literally meaning. We do believe that when, once the lady or the man stop committing a sin, he lost that title of sin. If someone was a drug dealer and he made tawbah, so his title now is not a drug dealer. He's Habibullah, he's a beloved one to Allah. So let's say some people made haram many years ago. So you say, Sheikh, I'm a zani because I was reading on Quran and Allah said, I'm adulterer. I said, no, who you are now? Are you doing it now? He said, no, so it's not you. That is a history. So now we're judging you from the current time, that time here. The other thing also, if you really want to make a practical tawbah, regret. And blame yourself and don't have it in a good memory. And then have intention now that you won't do it again. So it is a secret between you and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Stop sinning, regret about the past, have no intention to do it in the future. And then when the future come, we'll take it from there. But on that moment of Tawbah, you have to have that tree. The other thing, greatest thing you have to do it, is practical Tawbah. Forgive the others. How come you cry for Allah to forgive you, but you don't want to forgive your wife or your enemy? And وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. It's not easy only for those who fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So forgive those who did harm you, because Allah, you ask Allah, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you like that Allah forgive you? Yes, Ya Allah. So أُحِبُّ يَا رَبِّي. As Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, he said, okay, you have some forgiveness to your brother, do it and I'll accept your tawbah. The other thing also, which is very important for the practical tawbah, you have to recover from that problem. You have to compensate. Anyone who was delaying, you speed up. Anyone who did not study, you must make extra hours for study. So they call it uwad. Inna al-hasanat yudhibna al-sayyi'at. When you double your good deeds, definitely it will remove the bad deeds. And subhanallah, definitely Allah is Tawwab al-Rahim, definitely. We love our Allah for that ni'mat, it's called Tawbah. So, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. The good deeds remove the bad deeds. But there's no ayah said, إِنَّ السَّيِّئَاتِ, the other way around, never. Otherwise, it's going to be a big problem. So, good deeds remove the bad deeds. Another thing, Qur'an al-Kareem. Read the Quran al-Kareem and learn the Quran al-Kareem each and every second and word you read it in the Quran al-Kareem will become shifa. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We revealed in the Quran shifa from that problem, rahmah, that you will never do that problem to the believer. Another thing also, adhan is tawbah. Repeat, we can't all of us give adhan because we need one muadhin. Repeat after the muadhin is tawbah, is kafara. Many people heard adhan and talking, say, wait, repeat after the muadhin, it's going to be tawbah. Same, exactly like istighfar. Another thing also, you got so many ways to remove your sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call us to the river, to bath and shower ourselves 5 times a day, which is the river of salah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the sahaba, when he called them for salah, قُومُوا إِلَىٰ نِرَانِكُمْ. Stand up and run with your fire to switch it off, to off your fire by salah. Yes. So this 5 times salah is a ni'mat from Allah. It's called hasanat. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. This 5 times salah remove the sin. Another thing also, great ibadah, very simple. You don't need to be educated, you don't need to be alim. It's called giving the hungry people. What a great ibadah, it'amu at'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with that little food, he destroy all your sin because of that food. Even you feed the animal or you feed the birds, what about human beings? So it'amu at'am. The women give water to the dog and Allah forgive her. So it'am al-ta'am, it's very, very practical way of tawbah. Another thing also, accept the calamity of Allah. Accept whatever Allah wrote for you. Stop standing against the wish of Allah or the taqdeer of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. When the person was walking on the road and he was coming from some haram and then he fell and he broke his leg. So what happened? He looked at the sky like this and he said, this for that. That accident now counted a payment for that. هَذِهِ بِتِلْكِ. This one is for that. So you call it accept now. I don't complain, all right? Put this one on my file. So alhamdulillah, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. You say like that, it means I do accept. And oh Allah, invest it for me, put it as a payment for that sin. They call it هَذِهِ بِتِلْكِ. The ulama, they name it like this. Another thing also, say Ya Rabb. Just use this word, Ya Rabb. I don't know, we say it, but we don't mean it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard Ya Rabb, Rabb is a sustainer. Rabb is a guardian, the sustainer. But Ilah is God. So we need to beseech Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and draw the mercy of Allah through that word is called Ya Rabb. When the sinner, when the pious person say Ya Rabb, Allah replied, Labbayka ya Abdi, here I am, my servant. But when the sinner, after his sin, says Ya Rabb, Allah answer him, Labbayka labbayka ya Abdi, give him two answers. Because we need that person to come back to the road of Allah and to the cage of Iman. You mother or father, Allah is the most high example. When that person had a dispute with his mom and dad, and he make a call and he say, mommy is take it very serious because my son came to me, definitely he's desperate. I will run to him. And that's called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wadood. Why wadood? He doesn't take it as a personal fight between you and him. You make sin, and for every act there is a react. You make a problem, we'll punish you. You make good, we'll reward you. You come back to me, I'll accept you. So I don't have any problem or personal problem with you. Allah loves you. That's why he gave you way to make tawbah. If Allah hates you, he'll never allow you to make tawbah. Another thing also, the ulama said, ibtaghi ilayhi alwasila. I don't know wasila, what you call it in English. Wasila, you must find a way to rehabilitate yourself from that problem. So many people, when we take wasila, the people say means. No, yeah, it's one ibadah, one good deed, you stick with it till you die. Someone took wasila, that he practiced the sunnah to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Someone said, no, I will be kind to my mother. Someone said, no, I'll make my tahajjud. Another one said, no, I will feed the miskin. So you must find the wasila which you are good. You know, we are not so bad for everything. If you are weak on certain things, you are very good on other things. So try to work hard to gain that wasila from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Another thing also, we have to study. We have to increase our knowledge. النَّاسُ أَعْدَاءُ مَا جَهِلُوا. People are enemy of what they are ignorant about. You don't know it. So the children, when you go to school and you fight with them to study, they think that we hate them. Because you don't know the outcome of the study or the benefit of that study. So later on, you say, Alhamdulillah, my mommy used to shout me for حفظ القرآن. Now I'm حافظ القرآن. I'll get 70 of my family to Jannah بغير حساب. And then, alhamdulillah, my mommy was pushing me. Now I'm a real housewife. I know how to cook. I know how to look after the children. I make dua for my marhum because he taught me something. My father taught me how to be a mechanic. He was putting a pressure for something. So, brother and sister in Islam, knowledge. Learn about that type of sin you commit. They say, talk about it. If you want to make people aware about HIV and AIDS, they talk about it. They expose it. So that people can have full information. So, if you're having a problem, type of sinning, so you must read a lot about it. Zina, khamr, see how serious is that one. Maybe Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will grant you some self-control and prevention from him by the tawfiq of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Another type of tawbah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave us is called husnul khuluq, good behavior. Good behavior, akhlaq. Our deen of Islam came here to this world just to let you behave good. وَمَا الدِّينُ إِلَّا خُلُقًا طَيِّبًا. I have so many things to say, but they told me that my time is up. Inshallah, next time we'll continue with more. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant us tawbah al-nasuh. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala place the belief of tawbah in your mind and your heart so that we can die, inshallah, clean. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count us as a muhibbin, the loved one to Allah, and mutatahirin, inshallah. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار إن شاء الله till we meet you again. شكرا جزيلا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.